Billy Sherwood talks about two classic Yes albums that are turning 50 this year. I'm John Beaudin from Rocky Stream Music.
Hey, there's some albums that have turned 50 years old, and as you might know, there's two Yes albums. The Yes album from 71 has turned... do you have any... I was 11, you would have been 5 or 6, but we both got to it, I'm sure, a little later. Do you have any memories of the Yes album?
Well, I know that I came in around, you know, Close to the Edge, Tales, is where I really fell in love with everything. And then I realized, wait, there's a few albums before this, and I went backwards and sort of discovered it. And, you know, the stuff on that record's incredible. You know, it's just such a great record. And I've had the experience to play a lot of it live, and it's just, you know, it's timeless, man. Great stuff.
And
still
Fragile.
Amazing today.
And Fragile was later on in the year, and it's amazing how prolific. Elton John was like that in the early 70s. They were just releasing albums back. But any memories you want to share about Fragile? Because that's a lot of fans' favorite, of course.
Well, yeah, Fragile is just one of those milestone records that set the tone for the band, and it just remains, it's like Stonehenge, you know what I mean? Those monuments are just there and for all time, and it's interesting to turn people on to that stuff. Who, you know, they're like, what's Yes? Who's Yes? It's like, well, check this out. You know, you play them those tracks, and it's just, it blows their mind because it's a mind-blowing record from tip to tail. And the artwork's incredible, too.
Arc of Life is a new album featuring Billy Sherwood. It's a new band, debut album, and John Davison of Yes, and a few other Yes alumni as well. We talk about some of the songs, and remember, if you want to hear the songs, we can't put them in these clips. There's a full feature on the new album on our sister station, Rock History Book. There'll be a link in the description of this video.
The last tune, The End Game, mentions politics in there. What's that tune about?
That tune was written around the crazy sort of election madness that was the first go-round of what we just went through.
Right.
And what side are you on? And we're just waiting to see what's going to happen here. And you know, do our voices matter? Hopefully they do, but who can say? And, you know, in this crazy world of politics and media mixing together and all that kind of stuff, and it was just kind of this feeling of apprehension was what we were trying to get across, and just waiting to see hopefully where things pan out, and hopefully it's positive.
By the way, how old were you when you discovered Jocko?
I think I was about 12 or 13, and I started, because I was a drummer at first.
Yeah.
And I was playing along with records. I'd play on the Yes records and you know, ELP stuff and anything that was like a challenge. And then I heard Heavy Weather, and I was just like, whoa, this is cool. And I fell in love with that band and still love it, still listen to it religiously. You know, but I'm a fan of all types of genres, but I tend to really dig the stuff in the prog and the fusion kind of lane the most, you know?
A few more clips from Billy Sherwood coming up, the next one in a few days. Make sure you comment on our video, subscribe to our channel, and share our videos, and buy a Rock History Music t-shirt. It helps support our channel. I'm John Beaudin. This is Rock History Music.